Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage BlogHer Editor-in-Chief, Stacy Morrison.
Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome. You are here for the fabulous, the fantastic, the second annual BlogHer Fashion Show. And the best thing about the BlogHer Fashion Show is all you need to be in style is your confidence and the willingness to rock it. Woo! Before we start cheering and celebrating and getting to see amazing moments of style and all of the women that we know and love and stand up and cheer for, I have the great pleasure of introducing the sassiest, the sarcastinista-ist woman we know. Sarcasm and fashion, they go together as well. You'll remember her from Reno 911. Yes. Rules of Engagement. See if we can get any guesses yet. And Bridesmaids. Woo! And this fall, she's starring in the new TV show, The Goldbergs, on ABC, so we can see her every week again. Woo! So please join me in getting excited and getting the energy going for the beautiful hostess of Ulta Beauty's LOLs and the MC of the 2013 BlogHer Fashion Show, Wendi McLendon-Covey.
What is this?
Thanks, everybody. I was backstage dancing, so I'm sorry if I'm a little winded. Such funky music, right? Bloggers, welcome to this fashion show, okay? I'm honored to be here representing my favorite place to just shamelessly go and sample products on my wrist, okay? Ulta Beauty, because you know Ulta is the official beauty sponsor of the BlogHer 13 fashion show, and that means tonight all of our models are blogger turned models, yeah. You didn't know you could blog your way into fame and fortune in modeling, did you? You can. You guys are on the right track. These ladies have been in the hands of the best in the business all day. They've been being taught how to put on, you know, a very dramatic false eyelash. They've been sprayed with gallons of hairspray. And look, there are eyes so smoky back there, the fire alarms are going to go off. I'm just telling you right now. All right? They're bringing it. They're giving it. Freely, they're not asking for it back. So make a lot of noise when they get out here, all right? Now that's a lot of work. That is a lot of work for 30 seconds on the runway. So why do we do that? I mean, I do it every day. I'm vain, that's why I do it. All right, without my makeup, I look like the ghost of Christmas past. I kind of look like that with my makeup, but you know, I'm working with what I have. I'm not doing the runway tonight, but I still took my sweet time having my friend Jordan get me ready tonight, because she had a lot of my faux spray tan to fix. Don't look at my shins; it's very obvious. Okay, so this whole thing that you're seeing, it takes a lot of effort. I'm 43; it takes a lot of effort. Okay, a lot of products. I look like a ghoul when I go to sleep at night, okay? Luckily, my husband, he sleeps in a CPAP machine. So, you know, there's nothing going on after midnight in our bed. I've got my chin strap on. He's got his CPAP machine. It's called coping. Okay, but I think we will all agree that the getting beautiful is just as fun as the being beautiful. And the hoarding of products is also beautiful. Yeah. It's true. It's true. Now, I think we all know also that the pursuit of beauty is hilarious. It's hilarious, okay? Such shortcuts we take, and, you know, we read magazines on little tips, and they're all nonsense, or a lot of them are. I'm sure every one of you here, if we're being honest, has had at least a dozen beauty LOLs in their life, okay? I will share with you some of mine. But raise your hand if you've ever said, oh, I'm gonna dye my own hair and, you know, this information on in the pamphlet, it's just a guideline. It says leave it on for 20 minutes. I'm going to go gossip for 90 minutes on the phone until my scalp blisters. How many of you have seriously applied blush with that itty-bitty cheap blush brush that comes with the blush? And it looks like, oh, you're going to the Adam Ant concert tonight. Good for you. How many of you, and I know there's going to be tears when I ask this question, how many of you have taken waxing into your own hands? I shouldn't be. How many of you have tweezed to the point of no return? How many of you have sat in front of your magnification mirror and picked so much that you had to cover yourself in Neosporin and cancel your plans for the weekend? Faux tanned yourself tangerine again. We don't need to get too much into that. Or worn a scrunchie in public. Thank you, madam. No intervention for you because you've admitted it. That's the first step towards healing. Okay, well, at Ulta Beauty, which is my personal resource for all my favorite hair and makeup must-haves, they have a name for these fabulous mistakes, and they're called LOLs, beauty LOLs. And why not just take a moment to laugh? I mean, come on, we try so hard. We try so hard, but just laugh and celebrate that LOL glory. And they're everywhere. Beauty LOLs are everywhere. Not tonight. I mean, everybody here looks amazing. I've personally, in the last week, had many LOLs of my own. For example, you know, I read an article, and my mom used to do this. In a pinch, you can use lipstick as blush and eyeshadow. I mean, you can use a Sharpie as an eyebrow pencil. It doesn't mean you should. You put that lipstick on your eyelids, and it's like, oh no, have you been crying? Do you need a Benadryl? What's wrong? I'm concerned. And this is something I do all the time, and I don't know why I keep doing it, but I'll go to hug a man. And I'll hug a man and leave my imprint all over his suit, leave lipstick on the collar, get him in trouble, and then deny it. I'm totally denying it. I don't wear makeup. What are you talking about? Have you ever heated up your eyelash curler over a votive candle? And then, you know, it works. Once you heat that thing up, your eyelashes stand at attention, but it also sort of tattoos and burns your eyelid. And I've done that so many times. Have you also tried the cup of apple cider vinegar to get your hair shiny? Again, it works. And you smell like yesterday's coleslaw. My beauty philosophy, if I can sum it up, is to age is human, to cover it with concealer, and then avoid sitting next to a window or any natural light is divine. I'm glad you're clapping at that. I see you share my philosophy. So those are just my recent claims to fame, but let's hear yours, ladies. You know, we have a booth where you can come and give us your beauty LOLs and make a video of it, put it on your blogs. And you know, your readers want to hear that from you. They want to see, they want to laugh. They want to laugh with you. So aren't we most beautiful when we're laughing? I think so. I'm most beautiful when I'm having a big belly laugh and Diet Coke is shooting out of my nose. After I've burned my eyelids and then applied lipstick to it, you know. So come on, let's let our collective hair down tonight, all right? Pop into one of our Ulta Beauty LOLs video booths after the fashion show. Submit your hilarious horror stories because you get a chance to win $2,000 in Ulta bucks. That's a lot. That's pretty good. I mean, I can spend $2,000 in Ulta just, you know, on a Wednesday for no reason, just because I hoard. That's another blog, or that's another convention. But Ulta wants to see your LOLs. You want to win, and your readers want to laugh, so just come on by, say hi to us, do it. What is that? What is that? That's crazy. Is there an alien in the house? Well, anyway, to that end, I don't know what's happening. To that end, to help you continue the fun once you record your video, I've taken the liberty of curating a list of things that you guys could be blogging about, okay? To inspire your fan base. For instance, the fashion bloggers or stylista bloggers, hair extensions, to clip or not to clip. What do you think? I want to know. Do you watch Real Housewives? Any of the Real Housewives franchise? I like it when you can see the tape. And that happens so often, especially with Orange County. But anyway, career bloggers. Let's talk about accent nails. Everybody's talking about, oh, you gotta have an accent nail. You gotta paint your nails purple and green and whatever and have Swarovski crystals. Is that acceptable? Can you do that in the workplace? I mean, have you ever gone to a nurse and she's all, you know, blinged out, or a lawyer or something like that? What is too much? Tell us. DIY bloggers, did you find out the hard way? Did you find out the hard way that there's some things you should not DIY? Did anybody buy an Epilady or one of those like home laser LED things? And P.S., aren't Christmas lights LED? Can't I just like hold some Christmas lights to my face and get rid of my wrinkles? But are there some things that you found out the hard way that, you know, you should not DIY? All right, mommy bloggers, what are your favorite multitasking items to keep you feeling human? Especially you with babies, and you can barely get a shower in the day. Like, what would you invent if you could? What kind of cosmetic would you invent if you could? We want to know. Fitness bloggers, tell us, no, woohoo is right. Do you have any make under tips? Because I wear makeup to the gym. And I know that's probably not the best idea, but there's mirrors there. Or like, oh, let's go outside and have some, you know, let's be in nature, huh? Let's be in nature and go on a bike ride. I'm sorry, I need makeup. Or what do you do? Tell us. I want to know. I want to know what the right thing is to do. I could go on all night. We could stay here tomorrow with my dumb suggestions. But you're going to do it because you're the bloggers. And you're fabulous, so go forth and continue to celebrate the fun that comes with the good, the misguided, well-intended, whatever, and the truly beautiful. Because, you know, look, even when it all goes terribly wrong, we tried, right? I mean, I tried out of respect for you people tonight. I tried. And your iPhones, let's be honest. So on the subject of beauty, I want to introduce two of our favorite fashionista bloggers. And when you hear their names, I mean, you're going to give them standing ovations just on their names. Lovey and Patrice!
Yay.
Welcome to the second annual BlogHer Fashion Show.
Fashion show.
Are you excited to be here? No, you don't sound excited. Are you excited to be here? Woo!
Yes.
We have to thank BlogHer for having us.
We're so honored to be here. This is just a dream come true for both of us.
Yeah.
To be able to do it together especially is awesome.
Especially like, yeah.
Yes.
She's the yang. Yeah, you see it? And the last time we were both at BlogHer together, this is a true story.
Ooh, it's a little embarrassing.
What was that, 2010 New York?
2010 New York, we kind of crashed a couple of parties.
And we found a wine fairy.
Yes, and she was lovely, and if she's here tonight, thank you for the memories.
She's actually not here, and I may or may not have woken up the next day with a cheeseburger in my purse.
She did.
I can't explain it. I was just like, it
best
was a
roommate
good night.
Ever.
It was a best night ever. Hashtag
yep. Yes.
Best night ever.
And tonight is going to be an awesome night as well. We've got some beautiful fashion courtesy of Gift Bar, makeup courtesy of Ulta, And we were put together by the Gillard Jones Agency.
So they are in charge of all this fierceness. And I have to say, you look snatched.
Yes.
All of this.
Yes. I love this dress. I love this dress. It's Monif C. I feel like an angel. And you look awesome.
We are
balancing each other out. I love the necklace, the red pumps. Working it.
Of course, I had to do the red pumps. We didn't even introduce who we were.
No, I don't think we did.
Oh, well, we're terrible.
Okay.
Sorry, everybody. Well, I'm Lovey, and my blog is awesomelylovey.com.
Yes.
And I have a nonprofit called the Red Pump Project, so of course, I had to come out here in some red shoes.
Yes.
And you?
I am Patrice. I'm the creator of Afrobella.com.
Yes.
Thank you, everybody.
What is Afrobella.com? Look at her.
Afrobella is a beauty blog. It's about hair, it's about makeup, it's about life, it's about the things that fill you up and make you happy and make you feel beautiful.
And it's actually, her blog fits what tonight's theme is, because
yes,
it is about half woman,
half
amazing.
Half woman, half amazing. That is our theme. We've got kind of a balance between menswear and feminine looks and yin and yang and all of that.
So what do you consider amazing?
An amazing woman to me is somebody who kind of owns and celebrates their identity.
Yes.
You know, we've seen a lot of that here at BlogHer 13, and we're gonna try to represent the best as we can on stage.
So all these women are more than amazing, and we need you to show them support and love when they come out here, because many of them, this is their first time ever doing anything.
Absolutely.
Like this.
So loud applause, make everybody feel super happy. There's a little nervousness, so let everybody know
so,
that you're here for them.
Yeah, they are half women, half amazing, but they're all awesome. Like, they're like
awesome.
Beyond awesome.
100%.
So thank you to BlogHer once again, and we hope you enjoy the show.
Y'all ready? Yay!
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Half Woman, Half Amazing.
You better work.
Daytime.
Minute, hour, bigger, better, stronger, power.
Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Evening Wear.
Y Omega Latinos, let's rap. English, Spanish, Spanglish, lo que sea. Mami, no importa, yo te doy lo que quieras. Dale.
I'm excuses now. I'm talking here and now. I'm talking here and now. Let's go. Your time is running out. I'm talking here and now. I'm talking here and now.
It's not about what you've done, it's about what you do. It's all about where you go.
Such an amazing experience for all of us.
Yeah, we had a blast. I hope you guys had fun. Did you have fun?
Yay.